Hi friends, welcome to Biology Tutor. If you like this channel, please share and subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell button for notification. Today we are going to discuss about some of the milk products like cream, malai, butter and ghee. Dairy products, about 50% of total milk produced in India is converted into traditional Indian dairy products. Dairy products can be classified as fat-rich products like cream, butter, ghee, makhan, malai, cultured or fermented products like dahi or curd, yogurt, chakka, shrikhand, concentrated, partially desiccated products like khova, rabri, basundi, heat and acid coagulated products like paneer, chana, cereal based puddings like kheer and payasam, frozen products like ice cream, kulfi, malai ka barf, milk ice, condensed and dried milks, evaporated milk, condensed milk, milk powder. Whole milk powder and skim milk powder are there. Fat-rich products, cream, butter, malai. Malai means clotted cream. Makhan means desi butter and ghee. These are the traditional Indian dairy products. These are the indigenous products. Cream. Cream is the fatty portion of milk which rises to the top of milk on quiescent storage and is rich in fat. Cream is produced by separation of unhomogenized whole milk. It is an oil in water emulsion. It shall be free from starch and other ingredients foreign to milk. According to Food Safety Standard Authority of India, cream can be grouped in three different categories. They are low fat cream, medium fat cream and high fat cream. Low fat cream means minimum 25% milk fat. Medium fat cream contains minimum 40% milk fat and high fat cream which has minimum 60% milk fat. Cream can be broadly classified into market cream. It is used for direct consumption. Next, the manufacturing cream. It is used for the manufacture of dairy products. Next, the types of cream. Half and half means 10.5% and 18% milk fat. Half and half contains 10.5% and 18% milk fat. Light cream, it is also called table cream or coffee cream. It contains 20 to 25% milk fat. Whipping cream and heavy cream, which has 30 to 40% milk fat. Next, the plastic cream. Plastic cream contains 65 to 85% milk fat. Next, the composition of cream. The average chemical composition of cream is water 45.45 to 68.2% water, 25 to 60% fat, 1.69 to 2.54% protein, lactose content 2.47 to 3.71%, 0.37 to 0.56% ash content, total solids of 31.8 to 54.55%. SNF, solids not fat, 4.55 to 6.80%. that is all about the composition of cream production. Next, the cream production. Cream separation is based on the fact that milk fat is lighter than the skim milk portion. The velocity or rate at which the fat globules rise is given by Stokes' law. There are two main methods, gravity or centrifugal methods. First method is gravity method. Gravity method means this is the separation brought about by the force of gravity. It is the slow process. Bacteriological quality of cream or skim milk is very low over here. Fat recovered in cream is not more than 90%. Second separating method is centrifugal method. In centrifugal method, centrifugal force is used for separation. This is the instant method, high bacteriological quality and fat recovered usually in between 99 and 99.5%. Centrifugal method is much good than gravity method. Cream neutralization for butter making. It is the partial reduction in acidity done for sour cream. Sodium bicarbonate and calcium hydroxide are used as neutralizers over here in the case of cream neutralization. Standardization of cream. Adjustment of the fat level in cream to the desired percentage, conforming to standard requirements. Pasteurization of cream. Next, the pasteurization of the cream. Holding pasteurization 71 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes. HTST pasteurization usually 95 to 100 degrees Celsius for 5 to 16 seconds. Vacuum pasteurization. It is a continuous process, removes all flavors effectively but dilutes the cream and lowers the fat percentage of cream up to 6 to 8%. Vacuum pasteurization is not acceptable in the case of cream packaging. For retail sale, glass bottle, paper carton coated with waterproof layer of either PE or wax, LDPE sachet, plastic bottles or etc. are used. Storage, stored at 5 to 10 degrees Celsius and distributed within 3 hours of removing it from cold storage. You can see outline of the manufacturer in the right side. Milk filtration, preheating, cream separation, cream. Next, the standardization means the type of cream required. Next, the pasteurization steps. Next, the packaging, and the final step is storage of 4 degrees Celsius. Defects in cream. Flavor defects in table cream. Cooked flavor. Excessive heating of cream during pasteurization. Highly acid or sour. Using sour milk or due to acid development in cream. Oxidized or oily or metallic or tallowy. It is due to fat oxidation. Next, the rancid. Rancid means fat hydrolysis due to lipase action in milk or cream. These are the flavor defects in table cream. Defects of specific creams. Feathering in coffee cream. Excessive homogenization pressure using sour cream, addition of salts. Serum leakage, creaming, reduced overrun in whipping cream. It is due to partial churning or over whipping. Next, the cyanosis and aged flavor in cultured cream. Enzymes from the culture produce an aged flavor as a result of proteolysis. oiling off in plastic cream, freezing of cream followed by thawing, flavor defects in manufacturing cream. First one is barley. How this barley is developed in cream? Poor ventilation of milking byre or barn, not keeping milk properly covered during production. Bitter growth of proteolytic bacteria and lipase activity, which affects the cream and cause the bitterness. Cheesy growth of proteolytic bacteria that convert the cream into cheesy appearance. Coarse acid or sour, uncontrolled acid development in cream. It is coarse acid or sour. It is due to the uncontrolled acid development in cream. Fruity development of byproducts of growth of certain undesirable microorganisms. Yeasty means growth of lactose fermenting yeast. Microbial defects in cream. Bitty cream defect. It is due to the specific activity of phospholipase from Bacillus cereus. Next, lipolytic rancidity. Extracellular bacterial lipases of Pseudomonas species and other gram-negative psychrotrophs. Malai. Next is the malai. It is a type of clotted cream. It is of Indian origin. It is made by heating non-homogenized whole milk to about 80 degrees Celsius for about 1 hour and then allowing it to cool. A thick yellowish layer of fat and coagulated proteins forms on the surface, which is skimmed off. Buffalo milk produces better malai because of its high fat content. This high fat content helps the buffalo milk to produce better malai. It is a major ingredient in malai kofta and in sweet dishes like malai petha, ras malai and malai kulfi. Next, the butter. Butter is defined as fat concentrate which is obtained by churning cream, gathering the fat into a compact mass and then working it. It is a water in oil type of an emulsion. According to FSSAI, butter may be of following types. The first one is table butter. Table butter shall be made from pasteurized cream. Standards 80% of fat. This butter contains 80% of fat, 16% of moisture, 1.5% of SNF and 3% salt. Next, the cooking butter or desi butter. Standards 76% milk fat. Next, the additives used. Colors. First one, colors. Colors like curcumin, beta carotene, carotene usually of 100 ppm. Annatto extract usually of 20 ppm. Acidity regulators. Sodium and calcium hydroxide. The permitted limit is 2000 ppm. Classification of butter. Based on acidity of cream used for butter making. First one is the sweet cream butter. Sweet cream butter having pH of greater than or equal to 6.4. Acidity of the churned cream does not exceed 0.2%. Next, the mildly acidified butter. pH in the range of 5.2 to 6.3. Third one, sour cream butter having pH greater than or equal to 5.1. Usually made from ripened cream, more than 0.2% acidity. Based on the salt content. Next, the based on the salt content. First one, salted butter. Salt has been added and it improves flavor and keeping quality of the butter. Next, the second one, unsalted butter. It contains no salt, prepared for manufacturing other products such as ghee and butter oil. Based on NBUs followed by BIS. First one, table butter. It is made from pasteurized cream with or without ripening. Addition of common salt is over here. Annatto or carotene as coloring matter and diacetyl as flavoring agent. Next, the white butter, the second one. It is made from pasteurized cream without ripening and without adding any of or any preservative, including common salt, coloring matter or flavoring agent. That is known as white butter. Based on the manufacturing practices followed by Food Safety Standard Authority of India. The first one is pasteurized cream butter or pasteurized table butter. It is made from pasteurized sweet cream. Second one is desi butter. It is obtained by traditional process of churning dahi or malai as practiced as at domestic levels. Composition of butter. Fat percentage 80% to 83%. Moisture 15.5% to 16%. Salt 0% to 3%. And curd 1% to 1.5%. Butter is high calorie food. 100 gram of butter provides almost 700 kilocalorie of energy. Qualities of butter, such as a softer fat and lower melting point, is due to significant amount of short chain fatty acids. Butyric acid. Smallest fatty acid in butter is butyric acid. Outline of manufacturing. Receiving milk, preheating, separation, cream neutralization, standardization for fat, pasteurization and cooling, addition of culture, next ripening, cooling and aging, churning and washing, addition of butter color, next the salting and working of buff butter, next the packaging and storage, neutralization of cream. Cream should be neutralized to 0.06% lactic acid for butter for long storage, 0.3% lactic acid butter for early consumption. Two groups, namely lime neutralizers. Low, medium and high magnesium limes are there in lime neutralizers. Soda neutralizers. Bicarbonate of soda or baking soda, sodium carbonates are there in soda neutralizers. Standardization. The fat percentage of cream is adjusted to 35% to 40% fat. Pasteurization. Cream for making ripened cream butter is pasteurized at 90 to 95 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds or 105 to 110 degrees Celsius with no holding. Ripening. The main object of cream ripening is to produce butter with higher diacetyl content. This step can be eliminated in sweet cream butter. Starter culture. Acid producing starter cultures are Streptococcus lactis and Streptococcus cremoris. And flavor producing ones, Streptococcus diacetyl lactis, Leuconostoc citrovorum and Leuconostoc dextranicum. Cooling and aging. Cream is held at cool temperatures for proper churning and texture of the butter. Next, the churning. Phase conversion step. Conversion of oil in water emulsion of cream into water in oil emulsion of butter. The buttermilk is drained off from churn and butter washed with water. Salt, if required, is added. Butter is cut, wrapped and packed. Packaging materials used are parchment paper. It is also known as butter paper. Next, the wax coated paper, cellophane, cardboard boxes and teak wood drums lined with food grade plastic. aluminium foil laminates, lacquered tin cans, storage for short period 4 degree Celsius is used, for longer storage minus 23 to minus 29 degree Celsius is preferred. Defects in butter, defects in body and texture, sticky butter means incomplete fat crystallization, greasy texture, butter is worked excessively while in soft condition, leaky butter means incomplete or improper working condition, gummy butter due to high percentage of high melting point glycerides, mealy or grainy butter, butter made from sour cream that is improperly neutralized with lime, gritty butter, undissolved salt in the butter, that butter is known as gritty butter, color defects in butter, bleached butter due to oxidation of fat, mottled butter, unevenness of color in the body of butter is shown in the form of streaks, waves and mottles, that are known as mottled butter. Other defects: yellow specks, white specks, green discoloration, pink color and moldy butter. Microbial deterioration or spoilage of butter. It is mainly due to the presence of psychotropic bacteria like lipolytic and proteolytic ones, yeast and molds. Color defects means the discoloration. First one, bacterial discoloration or black discoloration. Pseudomonas nigrificans is the causative agent of black discoloration. Fungal discoloration. A. Mold discoloration, black discoloration due to Cladosporium, example Cladosporium, Herbarium, Aspergillus, Hasmodendrum, Alternaria, Mucor, Rhizopus and Stamphylium. Brown color due to Aspergillus species, Phoma species. Muddy brown color due to Phoma species. Green and blue color, Penicillium species and Aspergillus species. Orange and yellow color due to Geotrichum candidum. Reddish pink color is due to Fusarium. Yeast. Black color is due to the presence of Torula species. Pink color is due to Rhodotorula species. Next, flavor defects. Rancid flavor due to bacteria, mold and yeast. Putrefactive taint due to the presence of Pseudomonas putrefaciens, coliform, flavobacterium, malolores. Cheese stains, cheese-like flavor due to gram-negative bacteria. Malty flavor, it is due to the presence and growth of Streptococcus lactis in ice cream. The formation of 3-methylbutanol in butter mainly responsible for malty flavor. Shung-like flavor, it is due to the presence of Pseudomonas mephitica. Fishy taint is due to the presence of Pseudomonas ichthyosmia and Geotrichum. Next, the margarine. It is a butter substitute. It is an emulsion of edible oils and fats with water. It is free from mineral oil and animal body fats. It may contain common salt maximum of 2%, permitted emulsifying and stabilizing agents BHA or TBHQ maximum of 0.02%. Key, according to FSSR 2011, key is pure heat clarified fat derived solely from milk or curd or desi butter or cream, to which no coloring matter or preservative has been added. Ghee made from buffalo milk is whitish with greenish tinge and cow milk is golden yellow color. Standards of mixed ghee. Melting point of 28 degrees Celsius to 44 degrees Celsius. Solidifying point 28 degrees Celsius to 15 degrees Celsius. specific gravity 0.93 to 0.94, refractive index of 40 to 45, Reichert measle value or RM value not less than 28, PV Polensk value not more than 2, sap purification value not less than 220, iodine value in between 26 to 38. Right side, composition of ghee, fat 99 to 99.5% in the case of cow, in the case of buffalo 99 to 99.5%, both are same, and moisture less than 0.5 in the case of cow and buffalo. Next, the vitamin, cholesterol, tocopherol, free fatty acid content. Just read that table. Ghee production. The basic steps in ghee preparation are concentration of milk fat in the form of cream or butter, heat clarification of fat-rich milk portion, amount of water is reduced to less than 0.5%. Removal of the curd content in the form of ghee residue. There are 5 different methods. The first one is desi or indigenous method. Traditional method, only 75 to 85% fat recovery is there. Direct cream method. Cream containing 60 to 70% fat is separated from milk by centrifugation process and is heated to 114 plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius in stainless steel jacketed ghee kettle. Advantage, no need for butter production prior to manufacturing of ghee. Third one, creamery butter method. Standard method adopted in most of the dairies. This is a standard method adopted in most of the dairies. Unsalted or white butter is used as raw material over here. Butter are melted at 60 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius in butter melter. Final heating temperature is adjusted to about 114 plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius. Fourth one, pre-stratification method. Butter is produced from aged cream of 38 to 40% fat. Butter heated at 85 degrees Celsius is kept undisturbed in a ghee kettle or boiler at a temperature of 80 to 85 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. 3 distinct layers are formed. Bottom layer is removed. Middle layer or fat layer is heated to 114 plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius along with top layer which contains floating curd particles and denatured protein. Advantage, production of ghee with lower acidity and longer shelf life. Next, the fifth one is the continuous method. It is used for manufacturing ghee on an industrial scale. High fat recovery is there. Next, the granulation and cooling of ghee. After these 5 steps, next step is granulation and cooling of ghee. Granulation is important criterion of quality. It is due to certain content of glycerides of higher melting state saturated fatty acids like palmitic and stearic acids. Higher temperature of clarification gives better grain size due to high phospholipids content. For better granulation, ghee should be slowly cooled to 28 degrees Celsius in 2 to 3 hours time. Packaging, tin cans, glass bottles, semi-rigid containers like HDPE PET bottles, PVC bottles, lined cartons and tetra packs are used. Flexible films, pouches, laminates, sachets made from a laminate of PVDC, PVC, aluminium foil, PPR or long-term storage. They are used for long-term storage. Ghee can be stored up to 12 months at 21 degrees Celsius. Flavor of ghee. It is due to free fatty acids, carbonyls and lactones. The flavor is affected by method of preparation, temperature of clarification and storage period. defects in ghee, flavor defects, smoky fire used for boiling of milk or cream or butter causes smoky defects, flavor defects, overcooked or burnt, excessively high temperature of clarification, undercooked defect, excessively low temperature of clarification, rancid, fat hydrolysis due to lipase action, oxidized, oily or metallic defect, fat oxidation due to direct contact with copper or iron or to exposure to sunlight, texture defects, greasy, rapid cooling of hot ghee after clarification which causes greasy defect, appearance defects, burned color, excessively high temperature of clarification which causes burnt color, higher sediment, incorrect straining of ghee which will cause higher sediment defect. Thank you. If you like this channel, please share and subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell button for notification.